The player's page adopted the splitting of leaderboards to accommodate times that do not use PRB with track-specific rules. For example, on figure 8 circuit, you are only allowed to mini-turbo once over the grass portion with PRB active and then play out the rest of the track normally. The same would apply on SNES Mario Circuit 1, where the player can only complete the sand before the first set of pipes.
Great. What do you think players prefer out of both PRB and non-PRB?
So this is a good question. I think both categories are entirely different disciplines. From experience, PRB racing is generally more input-heavy and intense. You need to continuously mini-turbo to maintain boost and cut the off-road section. Whereas with non-PRB, down a few more pauses, you can be very track-dependent. Some players prefer PRB to get the fastest times possible in the game, while others enjoy the challenge of taking slightly different lines. Pretty much in accordance with the rules on the player page.
Great. How hard do you think it is to accomplish both perfect God standards?
So the non-PRB God standards were laid out back in, I think it was August of 2006, which was the main year into the game's release. Our knowledge of how far tracks could be pushed was still quite premature back then. So logically, these standards would be far more attainable compared to the ones in PRB. Players to this day, including myself, have achieved all non-PRB godships, though only one completed it for PRB, and that would be NK Dasher, famously in the summer of 2021. Needless to say, achieving the non-PRB god status is still extremely difficult. The only other player who I think can achieve
nice.
Is Japanese player Tiger, no doubt.
Him and NK I don't even know why I'm so nervous.
Quite literally, Ronaldo and Messi of Mario Kart, yes. So, yes.
842? What?
Is insanely hard. Because it took NK Dasher roughly...
9/11.
Yes, I think so. Well, thank you so much for being on. Yeah.
That's low. What the fuck? 1753, okay. That's kind of crazy.